Hey everybody, in this example we are going to talk about complex fractions. In a nutshell, complex fraction refers to the idea of having a fraction within a fraction. So in looking at this example, we have 6/11 and then a fraction bar, and then in the denominator we have 21/55. So we have a fraction, and then within the fraction, the numerator and denominator are also fractions. So this is what we mean when we talk about a complex fraction. They look a little intimidating. You might actually be a little bit scared when you see something like this, but hopefully by the end of this video, you'll see that they're actually not that bad. And handling them and dealing with them is less intimidating. So let's begin by recalling that the fraction bar is just another way of denoting division. So when we look at this example, we have 6/11 in the numerator, and then a fraction bar, and then 21/55 in the denominator. Well, this fraction bar we can actually rewrite as division. In other words, I can read this complex fraction as 6/11 divided by 21/55. Rewriting that using the good old division symbol, we have 6/11 divided by 21/55. Now our complex fraction looks a bit easier to handle because we know how to divide two fractions. When we have a division problem which involves fractions, the name of the game is to multiply by the reciprocal. Another way that you can think of it is using that catchy phrase, keep, change, flip, or some people say keep, change, switch. Either way, it means to keep that first fraction the same, change the division to multiply, and then flip the second fraction. So instead of writing 21/55, I'm going to write 55/21. Now we have a multiplication problem, and we can continue forward using multiplication. So you basically have two strategies. Your first strategy entails multiplying straight across, so multiplying 6/55 and then multiplying 11/21 straight across, and then simplifying your final answer. The other strategy involves a process that we call cross-canceling. It's my favorite process just because it is a little more efficient, and it means I get to deal with smaller numbers. And as we all know, doing math with smaller numbers is usually a good thing. I forgot my L there. All right, so let's go through that process of cross-canceling in order to finish up this problem. So the name of the game behind cross-canceling is to look at the diagonals. So you look at the diagonals numbers 6/21, and we're gonna ask ourselves, what number divides both 6/21 evenly with no remainder? That number in this case is 3. 3 goes into 6, 3 also goes into 21. So to cross-cancel, we actually do that division. We divide 6 by 3, which is equal to 2, and we divide 21 by 3, which is equal to 7. Now we do the same thing to the other set of diagonal numbers. So considering 11/55, what number divides both 11/55 evenly? Well, that number is 11. So we divide 11 by 11, which gives us 1, and 55 divided by 11 is equal to 5. So now that we have applied the cross-canceling process, we have a totally new problem which involves smaller numbers. Instead of 6/11 times 55/21, we have 2/1 times 5/7. Multiplying straight across gives us 2 times 5, which is 10, and in the denominator, 1 times 7, which is 7. So our final answer is 10/7. Now, just before we end the video, I'll make one last note here. Some of you may be tempted to turn this improper fraction, where the numerator is larger than the denominator, into a mixed number. We would do that by dividing 10 by 7, so 7 goes into 10 one time with a remainder of 3, and then we keep that same denominator of 7. So 10 over 7 is the improper fraction form. 1 3/7 is the same answer, but written in a different format, which we call a mixed number format. As you go on in your algebra journey, you will learn that the improper fraction is actually preferred. It's preferred because it's more streamlined and easier to deal with. So unless you are explicitly asked to state your answer as a mixed number, you want to state your answers in fraction form as an improper fraction.